Astronaut Randy Bresnik, talking to you about our spacesuits we use during our spacewalks. We call them the EMU, the Extravehicular Mobility Unit. What does that mean? It's your own personal spacecraft. So you can imagine that on your own personal spacecraft, you gotta have a few things. Well, you gotta have air to breathe, right? And it's gotta be comfortable enough temperature that you can go ahead and work. And our spacesuits have been doing a great job. We just had our 200th spacewalk on the International Space Station. But they do a great job making it so that we can go ahead and do these long, complex assembly missions and science missions and even troubleshooting and repair spacewalks that we've been doing over the years, because they keep the temperature constant just about inside the suit. We have the ability to go ahead and reflect the sun when it's plus 250 degrees in the sun. We have the ability to go ahead and warm us up when it's minus 250 degrees in the shade. We even have glove warmers that we can turn on to go ahead and heat up our hands so they don't get cold while we're doing the spacewalks within the shade. They also have micrometeorite protection in them. And so they also have the backpack that has our portable life support. And so it's a really, really amazing piece of equipment in our own personal spacecraft. Now, over to Marty and Beth so you can learn more.
Thanks, comrade.
The spacesuits that astronauts wear are actually pretty incredible. They have to protect them from the vacuum of space and extreme temperatures.
They also have to wear them, so comfort's a pretty big deal.
The other thing they're protected from is micrometeoroids, which are little tiny rocks that go around the Earth really fast.
In this activity, you're going to get a chance to actually use some simulated astronauts, or Taternauts, to test some spacesuit designs for micrometeorite impacts. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with a Taternaut here, and we're going to see what happens when it gets hit by a micrometeorite without any protection. So we're going to set him down here, and let's put our goggles of science on. Then we're going to take our simulated micrometeorite. It's got much more mass than an actual micrometeorite, but it's going to be going much slower, so it's a pretty good simulation. So we're going to drop it from up here and see what happens in 3, 2, 1.
Ooh, that didn't sound good. Let's see.
Ooh, that is one mashed Taternaut right there. So what you're going to do is you're going to actually create a spacesuit using different stuff you might find around the house. You're going to use tin foil, gold foil, some different cling wrap type things, and you're going to create a simulated spacesuit. Should we do it?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right. So there's our Taternaut, and we are ready to give it a test.
Okay.
All right, so we're going to put our Taternaut down here. We have our simulated micrometeorite again, and we're going to see what happens in 3, 2, 1. Oh, that was a direct hit. And you can see a little bit of a dent there. Oh, there it is. You can see a little bit of a dent there. But let's see what happened to the Taternaut inside.
Okay.
So we did have a hole in there.
Yeah, yeah. We got a little tiny hole right there. It went all the way through.
No holes there. No holes there.
Comfort garb.
This is so comfortable, the Taternaut does not want to get out of it.
I think we survived.
I don't see any damage on our Taternaut.
Now, if you want to make your own Taternaut, go to our website and check out our lesson plan.
Have fun mashing your own Taternauts.